Good morning, students. I am Naima Afrin, teacher of class 3 from Mahmudpur branch. Welcome you all to today's video online class. Dear students, I hope that all of you are fine by the grace of Almighty Allah. Students, look at this. What is in my hand? I know that all of you know these things. This is called scale or ruler. So are you afraid of scale or ruler? Don't be afraid of scale or ruler. Can you tell me why we have to use this scale and ruler? Yes, we have to use scale and ruler for measuring something. So can you tell me what is our topic today? Yes, today's our topic name is topic measurement, chapter 9, page 95. So students, have you heard this name of measurement? I hope so. In class 2 already you have some idea about measurement. So, students, at first I want to discuss about the basic things of measurement. Today our CW number will be 11, and first of all I want to discuss about what is measurement. Students, the answer will be, measurement means find the size, length, weight and volume of something in international unit. So what does we come to know from the definition of measurement? Measurement means to find the size, length, weight and volume of something in international unit. I will discuss about the unit after a few minutes. So everything you know in the world without measurement, we cannot make anything in the world without measurement. Why we have to need to measure the things? Can you tell me? Okay, I am telling you what is the importance of measurement. You know, students, measurement is a part of our life. In home to school and office to store, everywhere we have to use measurement. Okay, students, and measurement provides standard of everyday things and process also. Like you think, in our cooking also we have to use measurement for all ingredients. And not only that one, if you think that I want to take medicine, then you also you have to use a measurement of medicine, isn't it, students? You cannot take more or less standard of medicine. So students, we have to take proper amount of medicine. Okay, so now I want to tell you another most important thing about measurement, that is, there are types of measurement. Types of measurement. You know, students, the measurement means to find the size, length, weight and volume of something in international unit. So by using this definition, we can find there are various types of measurement. But today we will discuss three types of measurement. The first one will be the length measurement. Number two, weight measurement. Number three, time measurement. We will discuss about three types of measurement today. Okay, so today there is no writing. I will discuss about the basic things of measurement. Okay, so at first I want to discuss about length measurement. Our first type of measurement is length measurement. So we have to know that what is the length measurement. Okay, so what is length measurement. Students, the definition is length is a type of measurement. Length, again I am repeat, length is a type of measurement. It tells us how long or wide something is. Look at the word how long and wide. So from the definition we have to come to know length measurement tell us how long or wide something is. Look students, look at your book. You can look at your book also. There is a book in my hand, and if I want to measure this book, I have to tell how long is the book is and how wide is the book is. This is the example of length measurement. I will show you some example of length measurement, and in this measurement we have to find out the length, that is how long is the book is and how is the width of the book. Okay, this will tell us, which measurement will tell us these things? Yes, length measurements will tell us how long is the book and what is the width of the book. So I will give you some example now. Look at the screen. You know students, in our earth there are so many things, and among the things, some of their things that we have to take the length of the things, we have to find out the length of the things. So which type of things we have to take the length measurement, that I will have to show you. Look the picture, I have given some picture here, length of a pencil. So every time we have to take the length of the pencil, we did not take the weight of the pencil. Okay, so this measurement tell us how long the pencil is. Length of a football field, whenever we want to measure the length of a football field, we have to use the length measurement. Now width of a book, whenever we want to know that how long is the book is, then we have to use length measurement. So many things we have to use length measurement. Look, there is a height of the door, height of the window, it can be height of your friend. Whenever we have to know about the length of the things, then we have to use length measurement. So many example I have given here, like length of a banana, your my height, length of your arm, width of bedroom, length of highway and length of street. You know student, length measurement also tell you about the distance of, if you want to go one place to another place, sometimes we have to know the distance of the road, distance of the street, that time also we have to use length measurement. Okay students, so this is the example of length measurement. Like length, whenever we have to find out the length of a pencil, length of a football field or width of the book, height of your friend or yours, that time we have to use which measurement? Yes, we have to use length measurement. Look, I have a pencil box in my hand. So if I tell what is the length of the pencil box, then you have to use which measurement? Yes, we have to use length measurement in that case. Okay students, so students, another important point I will discuss you now. What is the unit of length measurement? You know student, measurement always express in unit. Whenever we express with unit, then we can easily understand which measurement it is. So every measurement has some individual unit. So now we will come to know what is the unit of length measurement? Look at the screen. The unit of length measurement is meter, centimeter, kilometer. Okay, students, length measurement, always we have to use this unit, meter, centimeter, kilometer. Whenever we use this unit, then we can easily understand it is the measurement of length. So this is the unit of length measurement. You have to keep in mind these things. The unit of length measurement is meter, centimeter, kilometer. Now another important point I want to discuss with you, that is we learned unit meter, and it is the M is the short form of meter, and centimeter short form is cm for measuring length. But look, when we measure the length smaller than 1 centimeter, we use a unit millimeter. Okay, students, we know that the unit of length measurement is meter, centimeter, it can be kilometer. But whenever it will smaller than 1 centimeter, then its name will be what? Millimeter. And most important point, we have to keep in mind the unit for length. There are two formula, and it is very important formula for you. And whenever we will do the problem, then we have to use this formula. That's why you have to keep in mind these two formula. That is number one, 1 meter equal to 100 centimeter. 1 meter, 100 centimeter. 100 centimeter can make a 1 meter, and 1 centimeter, it will be 10 millimeter. 1 centimeter equal to 10 millimeter. 10 millimeter can make a 1 centimeter. Okay, students, you can find in your book is a picture of a scale or ruler. Look, there is a zero. It has started from 0 and 1. And in your school scale or ruler, you can find there it has written cm, that is centimeter. So look, 0, from 0 to 1, there are 10 here. So 1 centimeter means how many millimeter? 10 millimeter. Okay, so here I have written 1 centimeter equal to 10 millimeter. Okay, students, now have you understood the length measurement and which things we have to take the length measurement? Students, I will discuss another type of measurement, and that is weight measurement. Now look at the screen. What is weight measurement? The answer will be, weight measurement is types of measurement. It tell us how much heavier an object is. How much heavier an object is. So you know, students, there are so many things in the world, and some things we have to take their length of the things, and some are the things we have to take their weight. So weight measurement tell us about the weight of the things. Okay, students, so another question from the weight measurement is very much important for you. We have to know the unit of weight measurement. We know the unit of length measurement is meter, centimeter, or kilometer. And weight measurement, we have to express the unit like this way. That is, the unit of weight measurement is gram and kilogram. We have to know the unit of weight measurement also, so that we can express weight measurement properly. So the unit of weight measurement is gram and kilogram. And there is another formula for you, that is 1 kilogram equal to 1000 gram. This is the very much important formula for you, that we have to know 1 kilogram means 1000 gram. And whenever we will solve the problem in our next class, we have to use this formula. So we have to know that 1000 gram can make 1 kilogram. It is equal. Okay. So students, now I want to show you the example of weight measurement, that which things we have to take the weight of the things. Look students, sometimes we have to go to the shop and we have to bought some vegetables, fruits, rice, dal for our daily use. So these things, whenever I want to bought these things, that time which measurement we have to use? Yes students, at that time we have to use the weight measurement. The shopkeeper will weigh the things, then he will give you the things. Like you sometimes you go to the shop and you can tell, give me 5 kilogram rice, 2 kilogram dal. We have to express like this way, isn't it students? So in that case of things, we have to use not length measurement. Okay, now it is the question, how can we measure the weight of the things, that how much heavier the thing is? Okay, now I will show you another picture. There are some tools, and by using these tools we can easily measure the weight of the things. Look at there. There is the picture of balance. There is a weight machine and there is another weight machine. Okay, by using these tools we can easily measure the weight of the things. And can you tell me what is this picture? Can you know the name of these things? Yes, this thing's name is weights. Okay, and the shopkeeper always use these weights to give you the things. Okay students, this is called weights. And there are in your books, there is also some picture of weights, that is weights, there are, it is made of stone. Okay, so there are so many weights in Bangladesh, that is 1000 gram, 500 gram, 200 gram, and 100 gram, 50 gram, 20 gram, like this way. Okay, and whenever you go to the shop and want to buy something, if you tell to the shopkeeper that I want to bought 1 kg rice, then shopkeeper will use these weights. Okay students, so have you understood the weight measurement students, and which things we have to take the weight? I hope that you will understand now. And you have to keep in mind the formula of weight measurement, that 1 kilogram equal to 1000 gram, and the unit of weight measurement is what? Gram or kilogram. Now I will discuss about another measurement, that is time measurement. So first of all, we have to know what is time measurement. From the name we can easily understand that time measurement tells us about time. Okay students, and as a length and weight measurement, time measurement has so have a unit. We have to use some unit for time measurement. What is the unit of time measurement? Already we have know this word. The time measurement unit is second, minute, and hour. We have to express time measurement by this word second, minute, and hour. And from the time measurement, we have to know most important point. Some important point I have written here, and you have to keep in mind because we have to know this formula, and I hope that all of you know this very well. Again, I am repeating that 1 minute means how many seconds, students? Yes, 1 minute equal to 60 seconds. Or I can tell 60 seconds can make 1 minute. Now next, 1 hour equal to how many minutes? 1 hour equal to 60 minutes. I know already you have know these things. Again, I am repeating. 1 day equal to how many hours if I ask you? Yes, 1 day equal to 24 hours. And 1 year equal to how many days? 365 days. We have to keep in mind. Okay, students, we have to use this formula whenever we will solve our problem. Okay? So, students, already we have discussed three types of measurement today. So, what we have to come to know from this chapter? We have to come to know what is length measurement, what is weight measurement, what is time measurement. So, you have to know the unit of the measurement. So first of all, again I am repeating for you, that is length measurement. And length measurement unit will be what? Meter or centimeter. And number two, weight measurement. And weight measurement unit, we have to express weight measurement by the word kilogram or gram. And number three, already you have know it, time measurement. Time measurement unit will be the word second, minute and hour. Now it's time for diary writing. So what will be your diary writing today? So write down this. Learn the units of length, weight and time. So I hope that all of you, whatever I will discuss today, you will read out it from the book also, and you have to learn the unit of the measurement, and you have to keep in mind the formula whatever I have shown you today's class. So no more, students. I hope that you will practice it at your home. Keep on learning. Bye bye.